Welcome back. I'm That Chemist, and today we have an absolutely normal tier list with nothing at all inappropriate. None of the molecules in today's video are any way unsuitable for YouTube. This is completely an appropriate video, and I'm sure you wouldn't have any reason to get offended. I can't imagine why anybody would be upset by this. If you haven't seen Markiplier or Moist Critical's videos on the Try Not to Get Age Restricted challenge, you can consider this video another video in the series. I'll put a link to their videos in the description. So let's get started with this absolutely appropriate tier list. So our first molecule is Benzoca Fluoranthene. This is a polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbon. I don't think that there's any reason why anybody would have issues with this one. There's nothing unique about its shape. However, this is a commercially available fluorescent compound, and it's an environmental contaminant that people look at. So I don't think there's anything too remarkable about this shape. I don't see any issues with it at all. But I just feel a real gut instinct to put it into A tier. I don't think that one could get our video age restricted, but something inside of me tells me it might. Now, another molecule which kind of gives off similar vibes is Fosgene. Not entirely sure why it gives off vibes, but this is a really toxic gas. Quite often we see this one on the channel where people are welding and they accidentally wipe off a surface with brake cleaning fluid, and they end up creating Fosgene in the process. So this is another really terrible molecule. We can put this in A tier as well. Now, if you're a fan of Scatol, you might have issues. But depending on the concentration, it might be totally fine. This compound gets its name from being the primary smell in feces, but it's concentration dependent, and so you can often see it in perfumes as a minor ingredient, and it can be pleasant depending on the dose. Now, if there's a really high dose and everybody else in the room is uncomfortable, you might be the weird one if you're into Scatol. So I think this is a relatively safe one. I don't think there's too many problems with this one. We can just put it into like E tier. Now, Fucidal, you gotta be careful how you pronounce this one or someone might get the wrong idea. Fucitol is a sugar alcohol derived from fucose. Fucose comes from seaweed. This is another totally innocent alcohol. You might be thinking some naughty things that maybe you have to go back to Sunday school to get rid of. Fucitol is probably also pretty safe. I think we can put that one into B tier. Now here we have TATP, and I really have to be careful what I say about this because I don't want anybody getting the wrong idea. This compound is very well known, and you shouldn't ever try making it. I have intentionally not talked about this on the channel, so this could go right into S tier. The next chemical that we have is phthalic acid. Now you have to be careful how you say this one. Oftentimes people will think you're saying phthalic acid, and we're not talking about anything phthalic in this episode. This is absolutely only phthalic acid. Oftentimes you have plasticizers, which are derived from phthalic acid, known as phthalates, and this doesn't even look phthalic, so it can probably go into E tier. Now, this next one here is pretty special, so I think we can save that one for a little bit later. Let's go right to methanol. This one's got a pretty interesting name. You know, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. There's nothing that immediately stands out to me. It just looks like formaldehyde. Some people call it methanol instead. I'm not sure why so many people in the Discord got worked up about this one. I think this is totally fine. There's nothing wrong with methanol. So I think we could probably also put this one into like D tier. I'm not really sure why anybody has any issues with it. This does kind of give off Fosgene vibes though, if you know what I'm saying. So this can probably go into A tier. So I don't want you to get too disappointed, but why don't we talk about Clitoracital? Clitoracital was an interesting one to try and find more information about. This one actually was hard to find, and if you don't believe me, you can try Googling its name. Nothing will come up. The interesting thing is if you type in this cast number, you will come up with compounds with this name. And the only way I was able to find this was by searching for this exact structure on Reaxys, which is a good structure searching tool that most universities have access to. And yeah, I did eventually find it, but it was a struggle to find it. The most ironic thing about this compound is it's a natural product, and it comes from a very unfortunately named plant called Clitoria fairchildania, and I will include a link to that paper in the description. Very, very unfortunate name. This one could go right into S tier. Okay, Urospermal. Urospermal is another very innocent, nice compound. Nothing too remarkable here. This is a Christian Minecraft server. I don't know why anybody would have any issues with this. This is a totally acceptable compound tier list. We're just talking about chemistry, right, guys? Yep, we're just learning about chemicals today. This is a glycoside, and it comes from Urospermum picroides. You can see that's where its name comes from. Again, not a particularly remarkable one. We will put this right into F tier. Now here we have orotic acid. Now this one might arouse some desire and excitement. It's got quite an interesting name to it. This is actually biosynthesized, and it used to be known as vitamin B13, but it was discovered that this was not a vitamin. It turns out that if you have issues with ammonia buildup, you can get erotic aciduria and acidemia. So orotic acid. I don't think there's anything wrong with this name, but I do have a bit of a gut instinct that we should probably put this into C tier. Now here we have a couple of real special boys. Here we have spermine and spermidine. Now you might be thinking that those names are somewhat suggestive, and they are suggestive because they were discovered originally from semen. Spermine was the first one to be discovered. It was discovered in 1678, but it wasn't until 1926 that the name finally stuck. You might be interested to know that the primary olfactory response to said liquid is due to the presence of said compound. It's also interesting to note that biologists use both of these compounds to try and stimulate the growth of DNA crystals. Yes, you can actually crystallize DNA on occasion. And so one of the things that biologists do is they'll have an array of different additives, and they'll put their saturated protein or DNA solution into each of these dishes, and they'll try and see if they can get really slow crystal growth to occur. Now, I don't know which biologist figured this out or how they explained to their supervisor why spermine stimulated the growth of crystals, how they ended up testing that. That sounds like a question for the biologists. I think both of these can go right into S tier because, ooh, these are pretty spicy molecules. You can actually see that we have this one again, and we can save this one for a tier list if we ever talk about plastic pony figurines. So tetraethyllead. Tetraethyllead is an interesting compound. You have to be a little bit careful about how you draw anything with a quaternary center like this. It turns out that tetraethyllead is actually a fuel additive in leaded gas. It used to be more common. It's used as an anti-knocking agent, and it's the most common cause of environmental contamination by lead. Some people really draw this in an edgy way, but because of the way I've chosen to draw today, I think this is fine. I don't think there's any chance that this could cause this video to get age-restricted. This is a totally nice chemical tier list. There's nothing special here that could cause anybody to have any issues. We're fine. So the next one we have is Pimpinellin. Pimpinellin is a furacumarin because it's got a furan connected to the coumarin, and it's a component of Angelica dahurica roots, which is a medicinal plant that is widely used in China for the treatment of symptoms related to allergic inflammation. Again, not sure why anybody would have issues with Pimpinellin. I do think this is a pretty pimpin' molecule though. It can go right into D tier. So this is an interesting molecule. This is submitted by Tay in the Discord, and I had to read this one twice because somebody in the Discord had referred to this as Limaspermidine, and it turns out that if I read L-I and I see the letter M, I automatically assume it says ligma. So this does not say Limaspermidine, and because there's no ligma, I don't think this can go into S tier. I think this one can probably go right into B tier. If you're interested about this compound, it was isolated from Aspidosperma rhombeosignatum. The first total synthesis of Limaspermidine was first completed in 1976. So this next one might be able to break its way through the tier list. The original discovery of this compound occurred in 1970. It was a real breakthrough in science. And it was discovered from the organism Hymenoclea salsola. This is another interesting compound. You can see there's some double bonds. We have this tricyclic scaffold. And I bet a lot of blood, sweat, and tears went into this project. This one can go right into D tier. So this compound here is called methamphetamine. And it's used to treat attention deficit hyper disorder. The US brand name is desoxin. I'm not sure why it would be called desoxin. I don't know how you could possibly have an oxygen that you don't have anymore on there. This is just like a normal molecule. It's just got a nitrogen on it and a bunch of carbon. Nothing too special to it. But my gut instinct tells me that this one's going to go right into S tier. Bastardane is this interesting molecule. Its name comes from the fact that it has an unusual ethyl group that links two parts of the ring. This is also known as the unwanted child of steroid chemistry. So because it's so unwanted, I think we could put it right into C tier. Although it starts with a B, so why don't we put it into B tier? This is another totally normal molecule with nothing unique about its name. This is another British cigarette molecule. It's called Fagomine. It comes from Phagopyrum esculentum monk, and it's been widely studied and found to be bioactive in several different contexts. This is a sub-member of the piperidine class of molecules. If you're not familiar with other molecules with similar nomenclature, I'd encourage you to check out the most unfortunate name tier list that was published on the channel a couple weeks ago. This one starts with an F, so it can go right into F tier. The name of this molecule definitely sucks. So we have a few left here. We have Viagra. I think we have to give this one a hard time. It's got some interesting uses, such as the treatment of erectile dysfunction and pulmonary arterial hypertension. One of the interesting things that I came across when I was looking into this one is sometimes if this is being used for increased blood flow to certain areas of the body, if certain inflammation lasts for a prolonged amount of time, not only can this have consequences for the area which is inflamed, but it can also cause is loss of sight and loss of hearing, which I thought was an unfortunate side effect. The desired effect of Viagra occurs through the inhibition of PDE5, which is phosphodiesterase 5, but it turns out that it also has activity against phosphodiesterase 6, which is primarily found in the retinal photoreceptors. It's interesting to know that one of the side effects of this drug is visual disturbances, including cyanopsia, which is a sense of blue-tinted vision. It causes everything to look a little bit blue. So this molecule might take away your blues, but it might make you see blue. And since this molecule definitely blew it, let's put it right into B tier. Now this molecule is going to get absolutely nailed. This molecule is an organophosphate insecticide, and just looking at this molecule, this looks like an extremely toxic molecule. I would not want to work with something which has an OCBR. That looks like such an unstable motif. This looks like cancer in a molecule. It's also got a really unfortunate name, and so I think we could probably put this one into A tier. But again, this is an appropriate name for a channel. There's nothing wrong about this list at all. This is totally acceptable. Now let's talk about Vaginidiol. Vaginidiol has an interesting name. In this case, it's actually related to its function. It's a coumarin derivative. You can see we've got this benzene ring along with this six-membered ring lactone, which is unsaturated when we have this whole fused 6-6 ring. This is called a coumarin. And it actually inhibits the biosynthesis of estrogen, hence the name Vaginidiol. As estrogen is essential for normal development of female reproductive tissues, this is like a consideration. It turns out that Vaginidiol also has an inhibitory effect on the growth of plants. So Vaginidiol, we're not talking about anything other than molecules here, right? This can go probably right into A tier. Now we have one left, and that's lactate. There's a lot to say about lactate. Lactic acid was originally procured from milk, as when milk goes sour, it tends to accumulate lactic acid through the presence of lactobacillus bacteria. Polylactic acid is used in 3D printing. Lactic acid is used as a disinfectant. And we're not talking about lactation. That's not what we're talking about on the channel. I don't know why you'd even be thinking about lactation right now. I don't know why I'm still saying lactation. We could just put this right into S tier. So hopefully this has been an entertaining tier list. And as I said earlier, Markiplier and Moist Critical have done videos on the Try to Not Get Age Restricted challenge. And you can let me know down below if you think this video will get age restricted. I hope you have a great day.